It's the best team in London, no, the best team of all. Everybody knows us, we're called Millwall. Let 'em come, let 'em come, let 'em come. Let 'em all come down to the den.
What's up YouTube, this is WiiPEOUTToPICS, and I finally managed to get my first discussion video up. And I know it has like been a while since I made that introduction video, but I was going to upload a video earlier this week, but things been a bit hectic because on Monday I had a bit of a, well, earlier last week, because on last Monday I had a car crash. I obviously weren't driving, but I was involved in a car crash, so things been a bit hectic this week. So anyway, my first topic is going to be not much else to talk about other than Millwall-Swindon player final, which I did attend and had to fucking sit in the top row, which was a bit annoying, but still. And yeah, Millwall beat Swindon 1-0. Paul Robinson with the goal, and I don't know, Millwall fans watching, if you agree with me, but I do believe Paul Robinson will be the next Neil Harris. By the looks of it, it's the way he's come up through the academy, and it must be a very proud day for him, having missed last year's League One Player Final and missing the FA Cup Final back in 2004, both due to injuries. So, overall, I do believe Millwall deserved to win. We were by far the better team. I later watched the game on telly and proper analysed it, and we were 100% the better team. Oh, cool, son. Oh, sorry, I'm just watching the Spain-Honduras game. Spain just had a chance. And, so Millwall, yeah, 1-0, and the celebration. Anyway, I was talking about the game, wasn't I? Well, Swindon, they did miss a very good chance. Charlie Austin, from a Paul Robinson mistake, the only mistake the defence made all game. Oh, fuck, what the hell was wrong with me? And anyway, Paul Robinson headed it down, tried to swim through, and it was due to a bobble, so that was really unlucky for Swindon. We did get away with that one. But man, just looking back on it though, the amount of chances Millwall missed, I can't believe how we only won that 1-0. I mean, I think it was a game of 2 hours. We had the first half, I think Swindon had the second half, but the second half, we caught them on the break a few times in the summer, didn't score. But yeah, anyway, celebrations at the end, I nearly cried. It was one of them games which I'll probably remember for the rest of my life. But commiserations to Swindon. I mean, I don't really like going around taking the mick out of Swindon. Like, we all know, all Millwall fans know how they feel after we lost last year. The only thing I will say about Swindon, what I don't like, is the fans, because I attended the last game of the season against Swindon. And obviously when they took the lead, they were singing like, "We are going up" and all that. And then when we took the lead, we started singing it. But then we found a news conference that Leeds took the lead, and they started taking the piss and all that. And I was just thinking, they were in basically the same position as us. They still had a chance to win our game. They should have been just as pissed as us. So anyway, but one of them things, we still got promoted. I do believe the Millwall and Leeds did both deserve to get promoted, because the way Millwall and Leeds had a pretty similar season, first half of the season, Millwall were quite abysmal. Leeds were absolutely brilliant. Second half, Millwall were top class and Leeds were abysmal. So, and back to quickly the Millwall-Swindon game, as similar it was actually to our defeat, apart from the fact that they didn't take the lead. They missed the sitter, as did we last year, Gary Alexander's header. But, commiserations to Swindon, man. If you're watching this, I do hope you do well next year. Like, you were unlucky, and I don't know, it was just me who was wondering about the Swindon right back. I don't know what his name was. He got booed by Millwall fans every time he got the ball, and I wasn't 100% sure. I found out after the game from Millwall fan, apparently he took the piss out of Neil Harris when he had cancer when we played them. But recently, apparently, his sister did die in Haiti. What the fuck was it? Earthquakes. So, yeah. And, apart from that, it was a good game. But like I said, Millwall completely 100% deserved to win. I hope people do agree. Amount of chances, I don't know how we didn't win. But back to our thing, yeah, Millwall promoted. Got the fixture list to come out. Our first game of the season was away to Bristol City. And the first home game of the season I'm hoping to try and get tickets for is against Hull, which I'm looking forward to, because last time we played them was in the FA Cup a couple of years back. And it did kick off. There was quite a bit of crowd trouble, so quite looking. That was never a sight, was it? Yeah, I'm just talking about Spain-Honduras game. So anyway, I think I'm going to end on that. commiserations to Swindon, and very proud of Millwall, definitely deserves to get promoted. And yep, I'm WiiPEOUTToPICS, and I hope to bring you a new discussion video soon. Please comment, like the video if you did like it. Obviously, if you didn't, don't like it then. And subscribe, Millwall fans out there. If you like the video and looking forward to more discussions, subscribe. If you're a Millwall fan, just subscribe. Nonetheless, just subscribe anyway. All right, this has been WiiPEOUTToPICS. I'm out. Bye.